Friends, my name is Abdul and welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video I will show you that how you can control the speed of a three-phase motor. The technique that we are going to use there is a space vector pulse width modulation technique that we are going to implement to get a three-phase sine wave, and also we will control the speed of a three-phase induction motor. So this simulation is basically a complete setup of how you can run and control, like you can run forward, you can run reverse, and you can speed up and speed down, and then you can stop. So these are the five functions that we are basically concentrating in this video tutorial. So the first thing from where we should start is basically the PWM, the controller that we are going to use. We are going to use the controller which is a Arduino Mega 2560. You can use Arduino UNO, Nano, Mini, or any other controller like PIC, DSPIC, or STM32F1, or any other controller. If you need help for the controller, like you want the code, simulation, schematics, PCB design, you can contact me on this email address thmed45000@gmail.com. I'll be happy to help you guys. So let's start. As you can see, the first thing here is a PWM generation Arduino Mega 2560. So what we are going to do is I have the program this controller in such a way that to implement the space vector pulse width modulation for three phase. So it will be generating three phase. So what we are getting here is the six pulses, two pulses for one pulse for each IGBT. So we are using six IGBTs for three phase. So we need three or six pulses. As you know that some of the persons there, some of the guys that you using three pulses, or the purpose is that you can control it a motor using three pulses as well as six pulses, but the technique is almost same for the both. But I would prefer to use six pulses. So what we are doing here is we are basically generating six pulses, and then these six pulses are given to a driver. Our driver is basically a module which is used to turn on and turn off the IGBTs or MOSFETs. As in this case, we are using here IR2112. You can use IR2110 or any other driver. The technique behind this is same. Here I am using IR2112, and the purpose of this driver is just only to convert this plus 5 volt PWM signal into plus 15, plus 12, depending upon the IGBT connected and the driver used. So here is the supply pin point, and here is a simple diode that we are using. Make sure that this diode is a fast switching diode, fast forward switching diode, and this diode is we are using only because we are giving this circuit only to forward bias, this not and stop the reverse bias. So what we are doing here is this is our common pin. So when we are giving supply at this point, then this thing is forward bias, and here we are getting plus 12 volt, and at the same time this bootstrap capacitor is charged. What is a bootstrap capacitor? Is basically a bootstrap capacitor is a capacitor which stores the amount of energy. It acts like a battery to store that amount of energy for a little while. As you can see that, or as you maybe know that, these IGBTs are, because of their fast switching, depending upon the carried frequency we are using. For example, we are working at 10 kilohertz, 15 kilohertz, or 20 kilohertz carried on the switching frequency that we are going to use here, and because of that fast switching we need a supply to turn on and turn off these IGBTs. So that at that some time that this bootstrap capacitor basically act as a supply to turn on and turn off those IGBTs. So this driver is basically converting your plus 5 volts signal exactly into plus 12 or plus 15 volts signal. So where we are getting our output at over here, A and B. Then this A and B signal is connected to these IGBTs over here, or most of it is. So this thing will turn on and turn off them. So we are using a three phase. So the output will, so we need 1, 2, and 3 drivers for them. So as here is a DC supply connected across these. So here is a DC bus that you can see over here. In my case, I am using just plus 300 volts, but you can use plus 600 volts or 630 like the ABB and other big designers like Mitsubishi. They are using 630 volt DC. So if you have like small voltages like plus 24 volts DC, then you have to boost it up at the end so that you can run a motor. So here is a DC supply, and this, because of that switching, our DC supply will be converted into three phase AC. And here is, I have connected a three phase induction motor to check that how the motor runs. Here is our control panel that we are going to use, and as I have explained at the start that we are basically implementing run forward, run backward, speed up, speed down, and stop. You can use more other functions, and it's very simple. So I only use here 6 functions just to show you that how this thing is going to work. So let's start the simulation and see how this thing is going to work. Okay, the simulation is started here. As you can see, the motor is stopped here, and these points are all off. So let's run forward. Here's the button, just click it. As you can see here, your motor starts running. You can speed up from here. And from here you can speed it down. As you can see that because of the heavy CPU load, the simulation is not running in real time. But if you run this thing in your on a real hardware, then the results will be pretty much good. You can stop. So here it stopped, and for the files like simulation and PCB design codes, you can send a mail at my Gmail ID and I will send you those files. But before that, please click the like, subscribe and share button, and if you like this video, thank you, take care, bye. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.